all eyes are going to be on the AI stocks this earnings season, but not necessarily the chips. I wanted to take a look at the hidden gems, the infrastructure stocks, what's going on with them, which ones should you be looking at? I'm bringing you five of them. There's actually more than five, but these are some of the top names. Let's dive right in. Okay, the first one to report and out of the gate on this video is Vertiv, ticker VRT. I own it in Zacks Value Investor and in my own personal portfolio, and it's been a wild ride, but you can see all these earnings beats, beat and raises, going back to the beginning of 2023. This is when NVIDIA was suddenly like, hey, we have this AI thing and we're getting all these chip orders. And then Vertiv took off. Now, what does Vertiv do? They are on the services side and they build out the data center. So they build the racks, the processes inside the data center, and they are partnered with NVIDIA and probably several other chip manufacturers in the AI build out in the data center. So look at the earnings growth up and to the right. It has been phenomenal, expected for 2026 as well. And now here we're starting to get 2027 further growth. Now the shares are busting out to new all-time highs this week, ahead of its earnings report. It better be good because they are pretty stretched. It is trading at a relatively high PE ratio now, but it's got the growth. Let's just take a quick look. PE of 44 now, but look at this PEG ratio, just 1.48. That's because on the earnings side, it is still seeing very strong earnings and sales growth. This is a company that's been around for a couple of decades. So to see 34% further earnings growth for this year, 26% expected again for next year on double-digit sales growth up here, 24 this year, 15.8 next year. These are all very solid in what you should expect as this rollout of the AI and the investment in it continues. These are the back end people, but this is where their business is booming, the best it's ever been, and this is their time. So I love Vertiv here. It is a little stretched, but as we saw on the chart, the stock has had a wild ride and has had big pullbacks. It had one in 2024, and then it had a Liberation Day sell-off here in 2025, and now it's back again. So you've got to have a strong stomach, but I'll be tuning in on Vertiv for sure, and I know many of you will be too, ticker VRT. And on similar vein, also in a similar area, Supermicro Computer, also in partnership with NVIDIA. This one, a little bit crazier chart because it did have some execution issues, shall we say, back here in 2024. And it just got a little too crazy, a little bubblicious, but it's pulled back. But look at that earnings growth here as well, expected, but has come down off of the recent highs. Let's scroll down and kind of see 23% expected for this fiscal year and 29% expected for next fiscal year. It is cheaper at 20 times. And then look at this PEG ratio of 1.09. That's almost a value PEG. So we have value and growth with Supermicro. Reporting, just reported. So we're going to have to wait a while until looks like next year, maybe. So this one, not on the docket imminently, but I wanted to include it because it is on the infrastructure side. Okay. Moving on. I want to talk about Sterling Infrastructure. This actually has the word in it. This is in engineering services. So they are constructing the data centers. And I own this in my own personal portfolio and in Zacks Value Investor. And this is a similar chart to Vertiv now, up and to the right with the earnings. Look at this great earnings surprise track record, very identical to Vertiv. It also has the miss right there in 23, and then it has been beating. This one is less followed than Vertiv because it is on the construction side, and you get a side bonus with Sterling, not just AI. It's also building the distribution centers for Amazon. And this year, it started building the next generation distribution centers. They've done the distribution centers from a couple of years ago during the pandemic, and now they're building newer models. And who are they hiring? They're hiring Sterling because they've done it for them in the past. And so they're building that out. So it's kind of a double whammy, a secret double whammy with Sterling. And look at these earnings, 56% earnings growth expected for this year and another 14% for next year. It is red hot. They've all got backlogs, but stretched a little bit on valuation, not as bad as Vertiv at 35 times. PEG ratio is a little bit pricier at 2.35 times here, or 2.35 on the PEG. Not in the ones like we've saw with Vertiv and with Supermicro. But Sterling, if you're looking for, again, someone who's going to be building or assisting in building the data centers because they're on the engineering side, then this is the one for you. STRL is the ticker. And then we've got to have someone cooling the data centers, and Eaton is in that trade. This is the old economy, ticker ETN, but look at this chart, very pretty. And up and to the right on earnings, no misses on the earnings surprise. And that's an earnings all-star. So I'm pleased to feature it here. Plus, it's the AI infrastructure. It's reporting at the end of the month. Look at the solid earnings growth, double digits for, again, what is an old economy type of company. But now it's in the new economy on the cooling of the data centers. And almost double digits on the sales growth. Will we actually see that as we go along and as this data center build out picks up steam? Maybe. But I'm going to be checking this one. What about valuations? 30 on the PE. So not quite as stretched, but not quite as good of earnings growth or sales growth. And then a PEG is reflecting that at 2.6 on the PEG. So not quite as cheap on the growth for Eaton, but I'm going to be tuning in. Just a great earnings surprise track record. So I'm looking for another beat this quarter and we'll soon see. So that's Eaton, ETN. And then I'm going to wrap it up with one that probably nobody has ever heard of, Wilden Group. Wilden Group, DN. This is it says business services. They are on the services side, but for the energy and utilities. And what do all these data centers need? Massive amounts of energy. I'm not quite sure where we're going to get it all, but that's a problem for next year and the year after that. But Wilden is involved in what is going on with the energy. It just says down here, professional, technical, and consulting services. And then I see utilities, private industry, and public agencies of the government. So utilities, that's what I want to be in right now. Big earnings beat last quarter. Look at that right there, 108%. Wow. And shares surging up higher, but off of the recent highs a bit. So maybe this is a buying opportunity. It is a small cap with just 1.3 billion market cap. That's why it's not widely followed. It's reporting in early November. So we've got it coming in just a couple of weeks. But look at the earnings growth on this year, expected 48% and then 11% for next year. But not a lot of analyst coverage. We do have two estimates, two analysts here giving us estimates for this year and next. So better than one, two is better than one. But this is one to keep on your watch list for sure for this earnings season. Got the great earnings surprise track record again. And this one also just this one miss here to start 2023. It's like everyone in this area on the infrastructure side had some difficulties in early 2023. And then it was NVIDIA to the rescue of the business. And that's what we are seeing now. So what about valuation? It's trading at 25 times. That's among the cheapest of the ones we've seen. PEG ratio is giving me NA, Not sure what that is, but let's scroll down. Price to sales ratio is just 2.1. So while that's not a value at one or less, like a classic value, that's pretty low, especially for these AI stocks. And then we have a price to book here of 4.9. And then how does that, it's a little bit pricier for its industry, but it's not like this is an AI industry. It's in business services. So we might find some other AI stocks in this area, but we're probably going to find a bunch of other kind of different companies that have nothing to do with AI. So it's a little hard to compare with the industry for something like Wilden Group. But I'm keeping this one on my watch list as well. And again, it's pulled back off of its recent high, giving you a little more value. Maybe this is a good time to keep it on your watch list and check out to see what happens this earnings season. But we had a huge beat last quarter. Here it is down here. And it's not even close. Estimate of 72 cents and it reported $1.50. So yeah, we'll see what happens this quarter, but I'm liking all of these infrastructure stocks. So let me just repeat them again. We had Vertiv, we had Supermicro, we had Sterling, we had Eaton, and we had Wilden Group. Several of these you probably never heard of. It's time to tune in, and I'm going to be covering more of these AI stocks as we go throughout earnings season. Vertiv is the first to report, reporting next week. So we're going to get a good idea about what is happening in the data centers and with the demand from the chips and the hyperscalers next week. So tune into Vertiv. I will be, and I'm going to be bringing you all of these. Be sure to get them on our YouTube channel. Go to zacks.com/YouTube. Put in Zacks Investment Research in the search bar if you can't do it that way. But get us some way, just subscribe there and you'll get all of these videos, plus our top stock picks of the week and Zacks Market Edge podcast and a bunch of other things. So just subscribe, get all of our videos during this earnings season. You don't want to miss it. I'll be back next week with some more earnings charts.